Hello everyone, my name is Abhishek and I am from Team RoboCart and welcome to the second lecture of app building. Let's open code.org. Now I hope everyone has an idea how to create their own account. If you have not created your account yet, please watch the previous lecture. So open your app lab. Today in this lecture we are going to build a simple calculator and then you can make some changes according to your ideas, your creations. Similarly, in your app lab we have a workspace, a toolbox and a simulator screen where you can see the actual simulation of your code. Workspace is the space where we are going to write our code, and this toolbox we are going to use this tool to write the code. Now, I am sure everyone has an idea how a simple calculator works. For that, we need at least two numbers as input, and then we can add two numbers, subtract them, multiply them, divide them. It's on us, right? For that, my user has to give two numbers as input. So in this toolbox, which option you can see for the input, I am waiting for 5 seconds. If your answer is text input, perfect answer. I am taking a first text input on my screen and the ID for this input is first, as I am going to save my first number over here. So the ID is first, and the placeholder ID is what we call this block in the actual code. Placeholder is what we want to display. So I am writing over here, enter first number. Now I need at least two numbers, so same block. For this one the ID is second, and the placeholder is enter second number. Now we have two numbers as input, first and second, but we have to display the result on the screen, right? So which block we can use for displaying the result? I'm waiting for 5 seconds. You can think about your answer. Very good, the answer is label. Now the difference between text input and label is, in text input the user can enter numbers, but in label the user cannot enter any numbers. This label will automatically show the result depending on the numbers and the operators. So the ID is result, as we are going to display the result over here. And the text is blank. Let's change the border width to 4. Now we need some buttons, right? For adding, subtracting, multiply and divide. The first button, I'm taking the first button. The ID for this one is add, and text is also add. Let's code for the add first. In UI controls, I am taking the first block on event. When I am clicking on add, when I am clicking on add, on event add is clicked, we want to set the result of this block. So set text of my result, set text of my result to the add event. So I am taking the add block On event add is click, we have to set text of result to addition of get number from the first one and get number from the second one. Now let's see, if I click on run, the first number is 54 and second number is 56. You can enter any numbers you want. And if I click on add, 110. Perfect. The addition block is working perfectly fine. Now let's add a few more buttons like subtract, multiply and divide. One more button. The ID is subtract and text is the same. Let's do the coding part. On event, here I was selecting add, so now I will select subtract. On event subtract is click, I am setting the text of my result to subtraction of get number from the first one and get number from the second one. The first number 54, second number 45, and if I click on add, the addition is 99 and the subtraction is 9. Now we have successfully written the code for addition and subtraction. Similarly, let's write the code for multiplication and division. Design. Two more buttons. Multiply. The ID is multiply. And text is same. I'm adding one more button for division. Divide, division. Divide, division. Now let's do the coding part for division. On event multiply is click. We will set the text of result to multiplication of the first number, get number from the first one and get number from the second one. On event divide is click, set text of the result to division, division of first number and second number. Now let's check. The first number is 45, second number is 65, addition is 110, subtraction is -20, multiplication is 2925 and division is 0.692307. Now I can add, subtract, multiply, divide two numbers, and it's perfectly working. Now similarly, I am adding one more button to show you guys how we can merge two or more math blocks. Okay, let's find the cube of a number. I'm adding a button. The ID will be 3 and text is also 3. I'm finding the cube root, or I can keep the text as x3. Code. Using the same technique, you can find square root, cube roots, squares, cube, you can find percentage and many more things. On event, this third button is clicked. On event, the third button is clicked. I am going to set the text of my result to multiplication and multiplication one more time. Now see, this formula will help me out to find the cube. Similarly, you can build your own formulas. You can merge more than two operators to build your own formulas. Okay, let's find the cube of a number. For that, I'll just pick a number from first only. For that, I will just take a number from the first number. So get number from first, get number from first, and one more time, get number from the first one. Let's see. If I click on run, the first number is 45 and the cube root of 45 is 91125. This is how you can merge more than two blocks to find cube root, square root, cube, square. You can find percentage. Now similarly, you have to create your own projects. You have to add multiple buttons and share the link with us on our mail ID support@robocut.com. Also, to participate in the competition, you have to download our mobile application, which is available on Play Store for free of cost. It's world's first free robotics and coding application, where we teach kids about electronics, robotics and coding for free. So please download our app and upload a short output video of your project on our application. If you have any doubts, any queries, you can comment down, or else you can connect with us at support@robocut.com. RoboCart is active on all social medias. Please follow us on Facebook and Instagram, and don't forget to share this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much for watching this video.